joy of my solo trip. The joy of my solo trip, Nandini.
Imagine this scenario. You walk into your office or college canteen and see all your friends and colleagues sitting at different tables, laughing away, chattering, and having their lunch. Then, in a corner, you see a person sitting all alone, having lunch. Immediately, you're probably going to label that person as being friendless or weird. You'd probably also thank your stars that you are not in that person's shoes, sitting alone. Fellow Toastmasters, we Indians are a gregarious lot, and we often associate being alone with being lonely. From loneliness, it's just one step to imagining someone to be depressed or a black sheep. In the same way, we often associate solo traveling with being lonely, and some people even say that it's so low to travel solo. In fact, it's one of the best things you can do for your personality, mind, and soul. It is probably better than having a love affair. My encounter with solo traveling began with a betrayal. That betrayal was no less than what happens to Kangana Ranaut in the movie Queen. Sure, I was not supposed to be on a honeymoon, but I had planned a week-long vacation with my friend to Puerto Rico. But when it came to the moment of commitment, the moment of booking the tickets, she backed out. I went on the trip anyway, all by myself. That's how my tryst with solo traveling began. The best thing about this love affair has been that I have never had to wait for anyone. Not for friends to match their holidays with mine, nor for them to have the same budget in mind as I do. So being to the beaches of Puerto Rico, the palaces of Russia, and the mosques of Turkey, without having to worry about other people's conveniences or bank balances. I've also never had to compromise with a friend whose idea of a vacation is to sleep through the day or watch TV, while mine is to ride a bicycle along a beautiful beach path. How many times have you had to cancel your plans because of someone else? How often have you had to cancel going to a museum or a bar that you really wanted to visit? How often have you had to let go of trying that local cuisine in a new place just because someone else has a rigid Indian palate and does not like to experiment with food? My motto is to leave the friend baggage behind and travel light, travel solo. Like any love affair, my relationship with solo traveling began with a lot of fear and anxiety. I was worried about staying all by myself in a room in a strange country, in a strange city. What if I could not figure out the public transport on my own? What if I could not find my hotel? But when I landed back in India after the trip, the only feelings that stayed with me were a sense of achievement and a sense of pride. I had done it alone. I had broken the shackles of fear. This overcoming of fear goes hand in hand with becoming a better planner. When I landed in Russia, the driver who came to pick me up at the airport looked like the quintessential thug. He had broken teeth and bruises all over his face. I was terrified as I got into his cab, wondering whether he would really take me to his hotel. But because I had done a lot of planning and research, I had a general idea about the layout of the city, and I made sure that he was taking me towards the city center where I knew the hotel was. So the amount of fear I have felt on a trip has always been directly proportionate to the amount of research or planning I have done for the trip. In the process, I've also become a better planner. There's another reason why I prefer solo traveling over love affairs. They say love affairs change you as a person. Solo traveling does that too, minus the heartbreaks. Whenever I've been on one of those dil chata hai kind of trips with my friends to Goa, I tend to stick to them and I don't really interact with strangers or new people. But when I'm on my own, I'm forced to do so. In the process, I have made new friends, shared breakfast tables with complete strangers, and definitely added a new dimension to my personality. In the same way, traveling alone actually allows you to try on different versions of your personality. Think of Ranbir Kapoor in Tamasha. When he is in Corsica, he is this jovial person who tries on different styles of Bollywood actors. But when he is in India, he is a grim professional. He is able to try on different personalities only when he is alone in a new place. That's what solo traveling does to you. It allows you to be whoever you want to be. So, you can have a boyfriend or a girlfriend or be single. You can be a singer or a DJ when life made you a boring chartered accountant. You can be the fool when normally you tend to be a quiet, sane person. When you're in a new place on your own, there are no expectations of behavior from you and no preconceived notions. This does involve a little bit of lies, but if it's giving you a high and it's not harming anyone else, what's stopping you? Lastly, falling in love, they say, makes you a better person. But falling in love with solo traveling makes you a creative person. Who knows, you might end up writing your first novel or at least a blog with all the time you have all by yourself. There's also a lot of time to introspect and reflect on your life. Whenever I have held the map of a new place in my hand, I'm actually internally mapping out the next few years of my life and how I would reach those goals of my life. In the end, love affairs do add a new flavor to our lives, but sometimes they turn bitter. For a long-lasting taste of beautiful memories and experiences, try solo traveling. Thank you.